My name is Juliana Sienna. I'm a fourth year radiation oncology resident at McMaster University.
On January 31st, we went to visit Dr. Sienna at the Jurovinsky Cancer Center in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Upon arriving, she gave us a tour of one of the several radiation units that are located in the basement of the hospital. Walking through what they call the maze, you are greeted with pleasant pictures as you approach the linear accelerator that administers the radiation. Now let's see what Dr. Sienna has to say about radiation oncology. How is radiation used to treat cancer?
Radiation can be used as part of treating cancer. The cancer journey might involve a medical oncologist, a surgical oncologist, as well as a radiation oncologist. And radiation might be used at different parts of the cancer journey. Sometimes we use radiation in a what we call neoadjuvant sense. That means before something like surgery. It can also be used in what we call an adjuvant setting. So typically that's after a surgical intervention. Additionally, radiation can also be used as the main modality to cure cancer, and it is sometimes used when we are palliating cancer patients. In other words, when we're trying to address symptoms that arise as a result of cancer. Radiation treatment can also be used to treat non-malignant conditions, but typically here, the majority of the work that we do is using radiation to treat cancer patients.
When is radiation delivered?
Radiation is delivered typically Monday to Friday, not on weekends, or usually not on holidays. The reason that we treat in this way is to take advantage of the properties of tumor tissue versus normal tissue. So we want to allow the damage caused by radiation to build up in the tumor to optimize the killing of tumor cells, but we also want to allow time for the normal tissue to repair itself.
How is radiation delivered?
When a patient comes for treatment, they'll come to the cancer center. Typically, they'd get changed into a dressing gown, and then they would be set up on the treatment machine. There's going to be a very specific position, and in fact, when they originally were seen for their simulation scan, they would have received small tattoos, and those tattoos are used to help line the patient up. It's very important because we've created a very precise plan for that patient, and having them lined up in the correct position ensures that we know when we turn the radiation machine on, we're actually treating where we're intending to treat. So we position the patient, and then everyone else leaves the room, and the machines are turned on, and the machines move around the patient. They won't see anything or hear anything. And in fact, they just sort of lay there. It may take anywhere from a few seconds to the most complicated treatments can take up to 45 minutes. And typically that depends on exactly how a radiation plan was designed. Sometimes a radiation plan can be as simple as one beam moving right through a patient. And other times, it involves multiple different beams at different angles that are all converging within the patient in the target tissue together.
What does radiation feel like?
For a patient, the experience is similar to having a chest x-ray in that they don't feel anything, except that the photons we use are higher energy.
What are some common questions patients have?
One question we hear a lot is there a limit to how much radiation that I can get? And yes, there is a limit. We have information from historical events such as the nuclear bomb in Hiroshima and the explosion at Chernobyl that have told us how radiation can affect humans who don't have cancer. And then we have lots of studies that have told us how radiation affects in animals and in humans, both tumor tissues and normal tissues. Using these, we have an idea of how much radiation each organ in the body can tolerate. And in fact, every organ has a different tolerance level. And so this is really important when we're making a radiation plan. We have to ensure that any of the normal tissues that are around the area that we're trying to treat are not getting more than what we feel is a safe amount. Sometimes patients will say, if I've had radiation in one area, does that mean I can never have it again in that area? And as a rule, in general, if you've had radiation in one area, there may not be an ability to go back and treat that area again. So that's why we take good we take great caution to ensure that we're giving the best plan at the first opportunity, because we may not have an opportunity to come back and treat that area again. Sometimes my patients will ask, if they're having radiation, am I radioactive? And it's a very reasonable question, but in fact, in most cases, no, patients will not be radioactive. The photons which deliver the radiation will pass through the body, and while they're still having an effect in the tissues of the body, the radiation itself is not still there. So patients are not radioactive and they can continue on with their daily life with no changes. The one exception to this is with a particular type of radiation treatment, an implanted treatment called brachytherapy, where a radioactive source is actually implanted into the patient. This is an entirely separate branch of radiation oncology, and in those patients, they may have some degree of radioactivity, and it would be discussed with the physician at the time of a consultation about what a patient might expect from this.
Thanks for watching. To learn more about radiation oncology, please visit the Jurovinsky Cancer Center website page on radiation therapy, or listen to our podcast on radioisotopes in medicine.